But obviously, you have a small park here, you have a, like a half a basketball court there. That was just recently, well, probably the last 5 years was improved.
Yeah, when would you need a decision from us?
Probably sometime within the next few months, I think. If, right now, I'm just looking for your support to keep moving forward. You know, there's no right or wrong answer.
So there's three options on the table, one of which is to relinquish it to the township.
That's the initial thought. I mean, I just want to make sure that we're all on the same page.
The second option would be to keep it and partner with the board and sort of work as a team to make whatever group decision is the best for everybody. And the third would be to
request all of it and take it off my hands. Somehow it was landed in my lap, but that's okay. It's been a fun project to work on. I've learned a lot, so. I think option number two is the best, only because right now you currently have that, and I don't want to take that away from you, because I really think there's some really good things that could happen out of both of our boards together. And if we can get some conservation easement money to put into a specialty fund for future projects, I think that could really lead us, you know. Not that we definitely, you know, I mean, the public has spoken. They do not want that to be like a Michigan adventure. They want it to be very naturistic. So what we were thinking is maybe formalizing some of this trail system with some signage, maybe a potential bridge crossing. I mean, that's going to cost a lot of money because it's quite, I don't want to say hilly, but it's got some pretty steep ridges in there. And I don't even know what a cost of a bridge would be in there. We may never get to that point. Mm-hmm. But I think to formalize, our thought here was to limit and not have any ATV usage at all, just to help protect those oak barrens. And then maybe have the northern on the top wall, it's the blue kind of crosses across. Make that maybe a limited bow hunting only, so we'd have no more rifle hunting. Because you're both, you know, having a walking park and rifles really aren't compatible together. So that's our initial thought. I know it's, I don't know how heavily used it is for rifle season now, but we're going to soon find that out. But that was our initial thoughts. We haven't, you know, obviously our steering committee is just a suggestion.
So the grant that was awarded, what does that speak to exactly in terms of what is going to be done with it or not?
The grant that we're with the National Park Service?
Yes.
That's just to help us develop a planning
document. So to help develop a plan, not to do anything with
it? No, once we get a document, they basically would kind of sway away and kind of disappear unless we needed them for additional.
It would become our financial burden to push forward with it.
Yes, and that's
not
where.
Not speaking of any particular grants that could be applied for later to assist in that process.
And along with that conservation easement, that could be good seed money to help maybe apply for grants, for match grants, or so forth. I mean, that's all probably down the road, but do you mind if Jan has? He's been a very integral part of the committee.
But there is a potential 319 grant that the Land Conservancy has available to it that could provide, they think, as much as six figures to the township for helping to develop that area and to put in some infrastructure, some trails, some possibly a bridge, as Carolyn said. So the National Park Service grant is separate from the 319 grant that may be available if we place the easement on this property. If we don't place an easement on this property, then that 319 grant is not available to us.
So that 319 is dependent on there being an easement?
Exactly.
Not strictly.
Pardon?
According to my understanding, that's not strictly true. I mean, the 319 grant exists independent of the township's decision about the conservation easement, if I'm correct. It would be possible for the Land Conservancy to approach individual riparian owners about individual conservation easements along the water course outside the area where public land is involved.
I'm speaking about the conservation easement on this property, which would allow for the 319 grant to come to the township. You're exactly right. If the township decides not to put a conservation easement on this parcel, they'll look for another opportunity. They'll look for another landowner who's willing to provide protection to their land. And when I say protection, what the conservation easement does essentially is to preclude
shell over it pretty much for anything being done.
It's what?
Puts a shell over it.
Yeah.
And I can tell you, from the board, and I speak on behalf of the board, that they're very, very in support of protecting that watershed and making sure that there's no development.
So their feeling going forward is that a conservancy easement is in the best interest.
Yes.
And
how to use that is still to be determined.
Sure, but our take or our involvement in it is the adjoining 19 point something acres.
Yes.
Right, to go with that.
If not, we've only got one access point. If you guys tell us no mas, we don't want to partner with you anymore, which I could hope you wouldn't.
Well, that's the proximal question, but looking ahead a little bit, of the two initial recommendations in this draft report, the second says, quote, the Fruitland Township Parks and Recreation Commission should establish a formal ad hoc steering committee to oversee early stage planning and development concepts for the Duck Creek Natural Area. That foresees a much wider and more substantive involvement of the Parks and Recreation Commission than just deciding about who's going to be in charge of this 20 acres.
Exactly. So are you willing? You don't have to answer me right now.
What other questions would you have, Tom?
That wasn't a question.
So I know it's just a statement.
Point of information, right?
Yeah.
So, you know, to what extent is any of this contingent upon us accepting this recommendation or not?
I think what we're looking for is support. The township board would like to move forward with the easement. I guess we could do that with or without you, because really the easement isn't going to probably affect you because of where the watershed is and where you're located, but I would hope that the Parks and Rec would want to partner with.
So we're going to endorse the idea of going ahead with this without accepting this recommendation.
Exactly.
Right.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. And you don't have to make a decision tonight, obviously. There's so many of you that are so new to it that I would hope that you guys would want to discuss it at another meeting if you have any questions, and if you don't, that's fine too.
Well, it's a big step in my view from repairing pavilions and painting picnic tables to overseeing the early stage planning and development concepts for this natural area.
Right.
Well, the important part about the whole project is the fact that whether we're involved with it or not, they're going to move forward, and then we have this opportunity to help guide that property at some point and either utilize it or expand it to be a park situation or relinquish. I like the idea of the watershed being protected. I like the idea of the fact that a majority of the residents and the individuals that have put input into it want to keep it as a natural area with very little or no development whatsoever, which is not to say in that bottom 19.2 acres that there couldn't be some kind of development at some point, a picnic area, a pavilion of some type. You know, there could, we could, you know, put a portable restroom there. The idea is that 19.2 acres, the bottom portion of it there, as well as, I'm sorry, I don't remember the name of the
Seminole.
Seminole over there, that there would be some parking. It would be the trailhead. Mm-hmm. So.
And those are just potential thoughts. I mean, we don't have anything written down. Obviously, we're going to have everything in this planning document to present, and it can be tweaked. It's going to probably be tweaked. But if there are initial thoughts of what we've gathered from the survey, the initial public gathering, and then the charrette, so, which we were very pleased and had a lot of great input and support and a lot of questions. So that's all I needed. I don't know if anyone... Oh.
And Carolyn, the document that Tom quoted from, that's still in draft form, right?
Yes.
Because I think what you quoted, Tom, I noticed that also, and what I was thinking, I haven't submitted my comments back to you yet, Carolyn, but we might want to rephrase that to say Parks and Recreation and the Township Board,
yes,
you know, collaborate on this. I think that would probably be a more prudent way, mm-hmm, to word that.
Yeah, I think he's got it more geared towards the Parks and Rec, and I think he fails to see that the majority of that is under Township Board jurisdiction. So, but he's thinking Parks and Recreation Commission. So I think it's just a matter of educating Michael. But But I'd like to see us keep partnering together and move forward on this. And once I get this, I'll be sharing that with you all.
Well, so you have in the way of deadlines that you're up against to get this information to?
While we moved ahead, we're getting the appraisals done with the Land Conservancy. I'd say probably within the next 2 or 3 months, we probably need to know whether or not we're in it together or what other avenues we need to seek, if that gives you enough time.
It's not, I don't think it's more of just wrap my mind around the
sure.
overall
yep.
concept versus the particular details. I mean, I don't...
I know I tried to share some of the information. I think you got it maybe last month or the month or two ago
yeah.
that Mary forwarded you, just so you kind of could kind of get a little bit up to speed, so to speak.
Yeah, teamwork always beats individualism
yes.
in this type of setting anyway.
And this
so,
has definitely been a teamwork action. I can tell you this committee has been
be,
very faithful
you know,
to this. So
more prudent for us, but I'd like to make sure we have us weigh out
yep.
all of the factors involved in that. To Todd's point, the you know, the specificity behind us, you know, being like the you know the godfathers of all the
sure.
it's quite a leap from you getting a picnic table repair to becoming involved in something of this depth. So.
Right.
I agree with Mr. Dewar on other grounds as well, because at the moment at least, it would be hard to describe the Parks and Recreation Commission as a representative body, since none of us are actually elected and don't have a clear constituency. I think until that is clarified, it would be inappropriate for us to take a lead role in planning anything.
But at this point, they're just asking for our blessing to move forward with it. And we will have an opportunity down the road, once the report is complete, to basically choose or do one of the options. And one of them is to give it all up. And the other is to partner. Partner doesn't mean that we have a ton of control over any of it. But again, it gives us an opportunity that down the road we may look at that.
It gets our foot in the door.
That's right. It keeps us there.
And we definitely, I think that's one area, and I can speak to from being here for almost 9 years, that the coordination of both board commission has been difficult, and I see this as an avenue to help build that bridge.
Now, is the partnership just for the 19?